Indeed, let us give praise and thanks to God because God is good. In fact, His nature is goodness. He is so good to us that He sent His only begotten Son to die for us. Through His death, you and I have another chance to life again. Throughout the past few days, we have been looking at things that indicate that the Spirit of God has left you. Today is the final day. We've seen four things that indicate that the Spirit of God has left you. The first one we looked at was prayerlessness. The second one was disinterest in spiritual things. The third one was presumptuous sinning and fault finding. And the final one we looked at was backsliding and withdrawal from the body of faith. So these are the four signs that show that the Spirit of God has left you. But the question is, if I have now realized that the Spirit of God has left me, what must I do to come back? How can I come back? Would I be accepted? My dear friend, the good news is that you will be accepted. He says in 1 John 1:9, if you confess your sins, I am faithful and just to forgive you. He would forgive you. So how do I come back? Well, let me share with you two things that you must do now to come back. Number one, fast and pray. In Joel chapter 2, verse number 12, the Bible says, yet even now, says our God, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. God is not just asking you to pray. He says, come back to me with fasting. So why don't you spend some time in prayer and fasting? And in those time that you spend in prayer and fasting, pour out your heart to God. Let God know your own condition. He already knows it. Confess your sins to Him. He is faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So come to Him with fasting and praying, with weeping and mourning, and God will forgive you. Not just forgive you, but He's going to restore you. He says in Isaiah 1:18, come to me. Come, let us reason together. Come, if you are burdened with the load of sin, come, let us reason together. So the first thing you want to do is that set aside some days and fast and pray and come back to the Lord in prayer and He will forgive you. The second and final thing you want to do is that you must then withdraw from all those people who were misleading you. Withdraw from all activities that was taking you from the Holy Spirit. Withdraw from all friends who were moving you away from the presence of God to the presence of evil. Withdraw, totally withdraw from sin. Cut your connection with anything evil in your life. Listen, it is better to break a heart of an evil friend than to break the heart of a righteous God. Cut your relationship with that woman whom you fornicate with. Cut your relationship with that man whom you fornicate with and come to Jesus, and He will connect you back to your Father once again. May God indeed meet you at your point of need. May He touch you with the Holy Spirit. May He empower you to walk on the path of righteousness this day and forevermore. Father, we thank You so much that You have revealed our true nature to us throughout the week. And we thank You that today You have also made us understand that it does not matter how we are fallen. If we come back, You will accept us. As we come back to You, Lord, I ask in a special way through the name of Your Son and the blood of Jesus Christ that You forgive us and restore us to our former conditions. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen and amen. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, and do have a blessed day. Shalom.